हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम विद यू विद ए न्यू टॉपिक एमएसए। सो बिफोर वी डिस्कस मोर अबाउट एमएसए प्रोसेस, सो आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू, आई हैव ए यूट्यूब चैनल, सो वीडियोस आर अवेलेबल, मोर देन 70 वीडियोस आर अवेलेबल फॉर डिफरेंट टेक्निकल टॉपिक्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एमएसए। सो एज यू नो, एमएसए इज वन ऑफ द कोर टूल ऑफ quality. So what is MSA? MSA is a statistical method which is used to evaluate the precision and accuracy of measurement system which is available in our organization, which we use during the production of the part for quality control and other related purpose. So dear friend, the prime objective of MSA is determined to ensure what is the capability of our measurement system so that we could produce consistent and accurate measurement results. So it ensures consistency and accuracy of measuring system in our company in part manufacturing as per drawing. So it helps us to identify the source of variability and error that may affect the reliability of the data, measurement data what we are getting. So there are three key elements of the MSA we are going to discuss. What are those? One by one. The very first one is measuring instrument itself, which we are using in our measurement process, like caliper, micrometer, different type of gauges, etc. So MSA, it evaluate the accuracy, precision and stability of above said instrument and determine if they are appropriate for the intended purpose. Another element is measurement process itself, which includes the process which is used to obtain the measurement, like setup of a instrument, setup of a job and collecting the data. So MSA, it evaluate the repeatability and reproducibility of our measurement process or measurement system. And third part is, what is that operator or the inspector who is doing the measurement, which include the individual who is responsible for collecting and as well as recording the measurement results. So MSA assess the human error which are related to measurement as well as while he is recording a data. So dear friend, how we conduct the MSA, that is next question in front of us. So what we do, we take a sample part or a product, then we measure same part or the product multiple times by the multiple operator. Here we use the same measuring instrument. So operators are changing, there are different operators and we are taking the measurement multiple times. So whatever data we get, that is going to be analyzed further to determine the repeatability and reproducibility of the measurement system which we have in our company for quality control objective. So there are three methods which we use in MSA. One is gauge R&R, another one is GR&R study, and the third one is ANOVA, analysis of variance. So what are different benefits we get when we do the MSA? So MSA help us to quantify the precision, accuracy and reliability of the measurement system which we have in our company to provide a quality product to the customer. It provide a basis for making decision on the appropriate use of the system and how we can improve it further. Another advantage is, using the MSA, we can improvement to the measurement system and it help us to select or identify more appropriate measuring instrument so there can be less chances of error during the measurement. And third one is improving the measurement process or training the operator so that we could eliminate or reduce the human error, or we can say error made by the inspector or the person who is doing the measurement. Another one is ultimate objective. It helps us to improve the product quality. Since we are getting the more reliable result, so our decision will be better, because whatever information, whatever data we have available with us, the accuracy of data help us to take appropriate decision, and we can control our process more and more efficiently. So now I would like to conclude. MSA is a critical step in quality control, because whenever you are developing a new product in regular production, you have to conduct MSA, and it is a process of continuous improvement which helps us, any organization who is in manufacturing, to ensure that the data which they are using to make the decision and control the process is accurate and as well as reliable also. They can trust, so they can take effective decision to improve the quality. So dear friend, if you like the video, don't forget to press the like icon. So if you want to know more, or if you want to connect with me, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, which is in the name of Ashish Agarwal, Corporate Trainer. So thank you very much.